Okay. Hello, mates. I'm Fernando. Yes, this is the third session. Yes, of this course. Yes, today we're going to talk about infinitives. The other day we were talking about gerunds. Have you done the exercise? And did you listen the video? Yes, of ello. Yeah, it couldn't be a very good video for you. Well. Gerunds are very important, but infinitive too. Yeah? When to use the infinitives is the other side, yes, of verb patterns. That is the part of the grammar that we are looking during these weeks. And these points are very, very important. So today we're going to focus in infinitives. When we use infinitive and not gerunds in English? Well, the first rule, yes, after these verbs that you can see quite well in this picture, yes, after these verbs, you used to or should use infinitive. Yes, this list, there are very common verbs like want, like plan, like learn, like hope, and a few of them that are a little more difficult here. Like, for example, perhaps deserve, or can wait, or arrange. But the most common are want, hope, plan. Yes, agree. Yes, these verbs are very common. Well, the English grammar said that if you use these verbs and you should or need to use another verb, you need to put it in infinitive and not in gerund. This rule is not so difficult like the other, because it's the same like in Spanish. If you translate the sentence, it's exactly, the literally, it's exactly the same that in Spanish. For example, I want to go to the supermarket. Yes, I hope to be soon with my relatives in France, for example. Yes, here perhaps the most difficult is, in my opinion, would like. When like, because you know that like, when you're talking in general, like, love, all these verbs, when you're talking in general, you should use gerund. But when you put good, when you are putting this verb with conditional, yes, in this case you should put it, yes, in infinitive, not in gerund. So be careful with that. Like normally is gerund, but when you put good will like, yes, in this case you should put it in infinitive and not in gerund. This is the first rule about infinitives. The second, that is a little more difficult. This is more difficult. Yes, this is the second rule about infinitives. After adjective, if you need to put a verb after adjective, this verb should be in infinitive. Yeah, very important. Yes, this rule. Like here in the examples. No, you have here the example. Yes, it is good. Yes, the example, it is good to review vocabulary, but it is better every week. Yes, so good is adjective. So after adjective, you should put it infinitive. But it is adjective, like here in the example, it is better. Comparative adjective, it doesn't change anything. It's adjective, it's a comparative, but it's adjective. So you should put, yeah, you should put infinitive. Yeah? Looks easy, but it's not so easy like it looks. Yeah, and there are complications about it. But today we're not going to comment more complicated cases. Eh? Los casos más complicados, we are not going to comment in this because it's pre-intermediate, and you have these rules are difficult. These rules are difficult. If you have these points clear, I think it's enough. Es suficiente. You have clear the 3 points when to use infinitive. Okay? And the last one, that this is perhaps the most difficult sometimes to understand. When you want to say what you are doing something, the purpose of doing something, in this case, you should put infinitive too. For example, I learn in English to go to USA. Yeah, I learn in English to work in a foreign company. Yes, when you are saying the purpose, el propósito, why you are doing something, in this case, you're always going to use infinitive, not gerund or other structures like present, no? Like I said you the other day. Yeah? So be careful with that one. Yeah? That looks easy, but in my opinion, perhaps is the most difficult of all these things. Okay? So, well, now we're going to put in practice, yeah, all that. we're going to do a small exercise. Yeah. With like the other day. Yes. We can focus. Yes. Here. You come into Agenda Web. Yes. We're going to see a few exercises. That way we can do it fully. Yeah. Today. Yes. Sorry. Coming here. We come in Bart's exercise. Yes. And we are going to Infinity Saint Jerome's. Infinity Saint Jerome's, you see how important are these points, yes? That with this second class we're going to finish now. And we are coming to lower intermediate, that I think is enough, lower intermediate for this level, for the classes of this level. Because this is a difficult point, eh? This is, we are going to start these points with a little of advanced grammar or anything else. Yes, we come in here, for example, I'm going to do that one. For example, here we have, John has decided, yes, here decided is a verb with infinitive, no? To apply, yes? He suggests, yes, suggests is one of the verbs that should be with driving, yes? That's the next. We can get used there. This is more difficult because we have done that one so good. Working. Yes, mother advise her. Advice, yes. Her. To write, yes. Yes. Carol is too ill. Ill, what is ill? Adjective. No, we're going to see that. So is infinitive, like today we say, yeah? To go after adjective, infinitive. Yeah? Have you decided where to spend in this case? Here's the next. I am thinking of after a preposition. The other day we say that after a preposition always ing. Yeah, of buying. Yes, he has managed, yes, to drink. Manage is a difficult, is not one of the best. Yes, my brother, good like, you say once, and once always infinitive. No, we say today, one of the examples, typical examples, to go. Okay. My brother, good like, good, when like have good, always infinitive. Remember, when don't have good, always ing, when have good, always infinitive. Yes, enjoy, enjoy is one of the verbs of the other day, reading, no? Or we say reading. Yes, and that's it, yeah, and we're going to check it. Yes, we check all, yes. But it's correct all, because we have done all. We have done only half of the exercise. But I think it's correct all the examples we have done. Huh? It's correct all the examples we have done. We have done only half, yeah, but all in blue, yeah, because it's all correct. Yes? And to finish off the lesson of today, we're going to see something with just ello, yeah, that is nice. You can come here. With you, and I recommend you, yes, to listen something else. For example, that one. Essential stuff. Yeah, this could be a nice game to do it. That also, if you have time, you can send me an email. What essential stuff you needed? Yes, the number of the ello, yes, is, because we don't have a lot more time, 974. I recommend you this video, essential stuff. You can write me an email if you have time. Huh? And you can... And you are looking for my email, you can send me. So thank you very much, yes, for the lesson of this week. I hope you enjoy, because this lesson is connected with the other lesson, with gerunds, gerunds and infinities. We have finished this stuff. Thank you very much. Have a very good week. Yes, bye bye. See you in chapter 4. Thank you, session 4.